Hi all, I have another very interesting opening trap to show you today, and again it's got high plausibility that black could play how it is when they fall into this trap, because I've actually fallen into this myself more than once in the last few months, and it's only when I'm checking with engines I realize the importance of a certain move. So let's have a look. E4, so you play with white E4, E5, pretty bog standard so far, as bog standard as you can get. Knight F3, Knight C6. Now the usual move here is the Royal Pairs. That's the most tried and tested move, obviously. But you can play the Three Knights game, which usually goes into the aptly named Four Knights game when the Four Knights are like symmetrical. So, and you can check Wiki for the Four Knights game. But as black, I thought there wasn't too much venom of Knight C3. And I was casually playing with black, Bishop C5. Do you know what white can do here, which actually gains more than a slight advantage? It's pretty rare so early on that you can get more than just a slight advantage from the opening, but here it is such a case. There's a very, very important trick to be aware of with the black pieces, why you shouldn't just treat it like Gyokyo piano territory. White is not obliged to play like Bishop C4 and transpose into some sort of Gyokyo piano. White has another move here. If I give you 5 seconds, what would you play with white? So starting from now. Okay, you can knock out an important central pawn. Knight takes e5. And it doesn't really matter what black does here. White's, getting a really good position, an advantage here. If black plays bishop takes f2 to try and expose the king, you can take this. And after knight takes, you've got the bishop pair basically. D4 driving the knight back. Say to g6. Bishop c4, I'll give you an example, and you can sort of manually castle rook f1 and then king g1, and you've got a clear advantage out of the opening. You're looking forward to potentially things like bishop g5 as well. Black's going to have to do something about that pin potentially as well. But there's the f-file, the bishop pair, the extra center pawn. It's very, very nice for white to start from that position. And if we go back after knight takes e5, let's have a look at knight takes e5. You fork the bishop and knight. And say bishop d6, you can take here. After bishop takes e5, you can afford to play f4 here. And you're just pushing black back. Now, if bishop f6, maybe even e5, you're pushing a nice advantage, a nice position. If black's giving up the bishop here, you've got then a very nice position still. Say queen e7, queen f3, knight f6, you can still push with e5 here, then bishop e3. It's a very nice position. Black's been driven back. You've got an advantage. So it's so simple, and it's something that I've been falling into, basically. It's because it's so seemingly innocent, knight c3. But yeah, it's sort of bishop c5, you can pounce with knight takes e5. So I think it should be pretty well known, but I didn't really, it didn't become very conscious to me until I started analysing the games where I'm getting these dreadful positions of black after playing sort of routine bishop c5. Yeah. So I hope you get something out of this, maybe try it with white, and let me know how you go. Post your games here in the comments of the video. Okay, thanks very much.